So recalling our prior discussion on the master budget, we discussed that the sales budget was the first budget you complete in the master budget process, because the sales budget is the cornerstone of that master budget, because it affects so many levels of the master budget, one being expenses and many, many other levels. So here's an example of a sales budget, and what I want to point out is, remember, this is a budget. This is something we anticipate or project will happen. And in this case, it's April through July. So here we have our April, May, June, July, the 4 months, and we have our sales types and total sales for each month. So notice we have two ways we can make a sale. We can sell items for cash or on credit. So you do want to keep these separate, because think about when they're collected. Cash sales, of course, are collected when the sale is made. Credit sales, on the other hand, can be collected 1, 2, 3, or more months after the sale. So when we get into our future budgets, for example, our cash budget, we would need to know what percent of our sales are on credit and when we anticipate collecting those credit sales. Do we typically collect 10% of credit sales the following month and 30% the second month, etc.? We would need to be able to make those projections when we create our cash budget. So let's look at an example of a sales budget. So here we have grippers. They expect to sell 4,000 pairs of shoes for $185 each in January, and 3,500 pairs of shoes for $220 each in February. All sales are cash only in this case, so prepare the sales budget for January and February. So the first thing I would do is set up my little grid here, and then set up my months, January and February, and we'll have a total column. The first thing I need to do is, what is my sales price per pair? Well, my sales price per pair in January was $185, and in February it was $220. The next thing I need to do is multiply those numbers times the number of pairs I anticipate selling each month. In January, I anticipate selling 4,000 pairs, and in February, 3,500 pairs. For a total sales in January of $740,000, and in February, $770,000, total sales over the 2 month period would be slightly over $1.5 million. So that's a very simple sales budget. And again, in this particular case, all sales were for cash. So we didn't really have to separate out cash and credit sales in this particular instance. And if you did need to do that, you could simply say, okay, our total sales for January are 740,000, and 60% is cash and 40% is credit. You would multiply the percentages times the total sales and separate those out for each month. So let's give you a chance to look at one. So here we have Mountaineers sells its rock climbing shoes worldwide. Mountaineers expects to sell 4,000 pairs of shoes for $165 each in January, and 2,000 pairs of shoes for $220 each in February. All sales are cash only. Prepare the sales budget for January and February. So press pause on your player now, attempt this problem, and then we'll come back and look at it together. Great, I hope that you were able to complete the problem without incident. So let's take a look at what we did here. So you set up your grid, then you set up your months, January and February, and your total column. The first line, of course, was the sales price per pair. In January, it was 165, February was 220. Your next line would be the number of pairs you anticipate selling each month. January was 4,000, February was 2,000. That gives me total sales in January of 660,000, and again, this is all cash sales. And in February, 440,000 for total sales over January and February of $1.1 million. Thank you for watching my video. I would encourage you to visit my website at www.accountinged.tk. Here you can find current accounting and business news, accounting business and education blog, my accounting lecture documents, access to all of my e-lectures as well as the accompanying e-assignments, and a bookstore where you can find great deals on books as well as textbooks.